here I was as a stay-at-home mom. I was desperate to try to find something in my life that my three kids couldn't have access to, you know? That was just mine. And because everything when you're a mom, they drink the foam off your latte. I mean, they have everything of yours in there. So I was either going to, like, take up smoking or write a novel because I needed some part of my day that they couldn't own. And I really did do it almost, just to entertain myself. I really had no idea that it would get published. And then when I started, you know, in the further, I said to myself, well, okay, look, here is this example of a really easy life, right? I spent 12-hour days, I was in trial, I had to go to the Metropolitan Detention Center, interview clients, I had to do investigations, you know, those, when you're a lawyer, you work constantly. And here's my husband. He works, like, what, 5 hours a day? And then he hangs out with the kids, and he, like, you know, goes out to lunch. This is the way to do it, right? I gotta do that. So it really was envy. And then, you know, lawyers spend a lot of time writing, so while I had never written fiction at all, I not even a fiction story, before I wrote my first murder mystery, I had, you know, as a criminal defense attorney, you write these things called sentencing memoranda, where you try to convince the judge what a great guy your client is and why he should get a lenient sentence, and, you know, how pretty much fiction writing. So, so in your first mommy crack novel, when she starts to work on her first case, the principal of the nursery school is killed.
Yes.
So anyway, the character who had been a public defender like you, you know, the main character, you know, she says, the problem with having experience as a criminal defense lawyer is that you count the same criminal violence everywhere, in everyone. Do you have any experience with people accused of horrible crimes?